Hey, this is Buck Dharma of Blue Oyster Cult, and you're listening to the Sports Circus.
Welcome to the Sports Circus. I'm your Ringmaster Sal, live from Las Vegas in the AMP TV studio, AAMP Television. Today's show is brought to you by UppercutChops.com. Check out their tasty selection of all-natural, dry-aged USDA Prime Wagyu steaks and chops. Wait till you taste their best-in-class New York steaks, the filet mignon, and of course the king of all those gigantic cowboy cut and tomahawk cut ribeyes. Best I've ever had. Probably be the best you ever have as well. Check them out at UppercutChops.com. That's uppercutchops.com, or give them a call. Find out what's for dinner. 714-948-0100. 714-948-0100. Again, 714-948-0100. Or visit uppercutchops.com. Yes! All right, a big welcome in, everybody listening in on all of our radio and television affiliates from coast to coast. The list is rather long and lengthy, so we will not get into it right now, but also want to extend a big welcome in to everybody that's watching on Facebook on Chicago Food Favorites, kind of a fun food page on Facebook, and it's for free, and hell, there's about 1,600 members or so of the group right now, and it's growing organically. Check it out, Chicago Food Favorites on Facebook. I welcome in to everybody also on Hotel TV and our cable operators as well. So, you know, it's a very sensitive time in America because of politics and all this other nonsense. But people are talking about why this particular election could be the most consequential election in college sports history. Yeah. Now, this one came out from Yahoo out of Washington. They stated, in September of 2020, during a contentious presidential debate amid the COVID-19 pandemic, college football found itself at the center of the political sphere. At that point, President number 45 announced to millions watching on TV that he brought back Big Ten football, saying that he had convinced the league executives to play the sport after they initially wanted to delay the season until the spring. A Big Ten university presence and athletic directors soon afterwards made clear that the conference decided to play football on medical advice and the increased availability of testing, etc. So, no matters. The claim suddenly thrust sports into a hotly contested presidential election. And of course, 4 years later, another division and divisive election arrived. And of course, while the act of playing football isn't in question, the act of paying football players is. And of course, that always gets an astounding round of boos from me, because college football players, I don't believe, should be paid when they're already getting scholarships anyway, which is their pay. Nonetheless, the election and congressional races, as well as the White House, of course, loom at the consequential point in essentially the history of college athletics. That's what experts, or so-called experts, are saying. As a matter of fact, Julie Sommer, executive director of the Drake Group, an organization whose mission is to defend academic integrity within college athletics, stated, quote, "Collegiate athletic policies, like so many issues, are hanging in the balance of the election," close quote. Now, think about this. The elections coincide, ironically enough, with the initial release of the College Football Playoff Selection Committee rankings. How convenient. While the top 25 has its own impact, of course, the election and their polls, of course, will have a lasting effect. And so, the results could shape the direction of college sports during a pivotal time of transformation in the industry. Don't you love how they stated the industry rather than in academia or the sport itself or whatever it is, but they have to turn it into something where it has a business life of its own. And of course, we know it does. The problem is they refer to it in a non-collegiate, non-scholarly type of a environment or in the way that they spin the rhetoric. And that's something I really don't like. Nonetheless, as major college athletics moves closer to a professionalized entity, federal policy looms larger than ever for college sports decision makers on at least three fronts: comprehensive congressional college sports legislation, the interpretation and enforcement of Title IX as it relates to athlete revenue sharing, and of course the debate over college athletes as employees. So, a longtime lobbyist working on behalf of the Collective Association, a group of NIL collectives, had stated, quote, "There hasn't been a time I can recall where every part of the college sports ecosystem, particularly the their traditional power brokers, have more on the line than the courts and the Congress," close quote. So, think about the legislation side of this. So the leaders of college athletics, mostly NCAA executives and power conference administrators, have spent 5 years visiting Capitol Hill, all in an effort to encourage lawmakers to pass congressional bill granting them protections to enforce their rules, many of which the courts and state lawmakers deem to be unfair. What's that all about?
Show me the money!
Yeah, I think it's a little bit about money. Anyway, in their most recent lobbying efforts, the conferences are requesting that any bill, first, prohibits college athletes from becoming employees, and second, codifies the NCAA settlement of the House antitrust lawsuit, which would likely entail granting of a limited antitrust exemption. I'm sorry, folks, but that whole thing, that is a violation of the Sherman Act. That is a Federal Trade Commission issue. Folks, if you don't know who the FTC is, you probably would want to go read about them and learn, because they're kind of like the boss of bosses when it comes to most of these other agencies, whether it's the FBI or the SEC or the Security Exchange Commission, the Federal Communications Commission, the IRS. They all answer to the Federal Trade Commission, in case you didn't know that. Nonetheless, 5 years and millions of dollars spent, the lobbyist efforts have produced one bill that advanced through a committee. That bill has not been taken up by lawmakers on the floor of the Senate or House yet. Of course, a stalemate explained through disagreement between Democrats and Republicans on concepts of college sports bill, all taking place against the backdrop of a split Congress, for now that is. Nonetheless, control of the chamber is paramount to both a passage and its content. And of course, is the bill broad or limited, pro-NCAA or athlete skewed? So an attorney, an expert on these issues, an alleged expert, sum up each party's contrasting approach in this way. They stated that the red team wants to limit employment status and give protection to the NCAA and power leagues to grant them oversight and regulation. The blue team emphasized more rights of athletes, express an openness, some of them, to employee protection as well as health, education, access, and gender equity rights. Over the last few years, a group of bipartisan U.S. senators have championed efforts for a college sports bill, nearly arriving at a deal in May of 2021. In their latest efforts, Republican Senators Cruz and Moran and Democratic Senators Blumenthal and Booker were engrossed in dialogue until election season ramped up over the summer, and Cruz, in a tight re-election race with Democrat former Baylor linebacker Colin Allred, is the bellwether, says Tom McClellan, a former U.S. congressman who's lobbied on behalf of college sports bills for years. In fact, if Cruz wins re-election and the Republicans win enough race state control of the Senate, polling shows this is probable, Cruz would become the chair of the key committee that controls college sports legislation, or the Senate Commerce. This is pretty interesting stuff, like it or not, but this is legit. Now, Cruz has publicly said he will make college sports legislation a very, very high priority, but even if legislation leaves the committee, it must be bipartisan in nature to get the approval of a full Senate, and the election results are not expected to give either party a significant amount of control either way to get legislation through along party lines only. And then it must pass the House, which could flip, of course, some contend from Party A to Party B. Whatever, a divided Congress could present even more problems. In fact, McMillan says, quote, if Republicans take the Senate and Democrats take the House, it's going to be difficult to get stuff done. If Republicans have a clean sweep, they could get all the agenda done. More likely scenario is a split government, and it's going to require hard work to get a compromise deal. And I don't see a clean sweep, close quote. That's according to McMillan. So you see, folks, there's a lot going on here. As a matter of fact, I would like to continue on with this, and I'd like to talk a little bit more about Title IX when we come back. This is pretty important stuff because a lot of us watch sports, either that or we've played in our particular sport, we've participated, we go to games, we put our money towards it, we buy these viewing packages and whatnot. So this does affect many of us here listening to the show and many of the people that we know as well. So we're going to come back with Title IX from the NCAA in just a few minutes here on the Sports Circus. Lots more to come, folks. Don't go anywhere.
Attention business owners, you and your customers are listening to this right now. Face it, every business needs customers, even yours. The Sports Circus is a primetime nationally syndicated program that's carried on ABC, NBC, CNBC, and Westwood One News affiliates, plus CBS, Fox, and NBC Sports affiliates across North America, with coverage from Hawaii to New York. Also, the Sports Circus is available to the 180 million subscribers on iHeartRadio, and the Sports Circus gets about 4 million website visitors per month, which could click through your website and bring sales. The Sports Circus provides great content featuring celebrity guests from sports and entertainment to our audience every weekday, which your company could greatly benefit from by increasing your visibility, foot traffic, eyeballs to your website, and calls from potential customers. Call us right now at 702-799-9935. Again,
702-798-0100.
Us at info@thesportscircus.com. That's info@thesportscircus.com. Drive your sales today by advertising with the Sports Circus.
Could you use a little extra money right now? If you'd like to borrow up to $100,000 and get pre-approved in minutes, call the number we'll give you at the end of this commercial. Our lending partners have already loaned millions of dollars to individuals just like you, and we're ready to lend you up to $100,000 if you qualify, even if your credit is not perfect. You could use the money to pay off high-interest credit cards, for home renovations, or consolidate existing debt. You can get flexible, easy-to-pay terms. The consultation to find out if you qualify is free. To find out if you qualify for our special financing program, call this toll-free number 24 hours a day. 800-335-1376. 800-335-1376. 800-335-1376. That's 800-335-1376. Important terms and conditions apply. Not all applicants will qualify. Loan amount, annual percentage rate, and term will vary depending on creditworthiness. Applying does not guarantee approval. Account approval is subject to verification and confirmation of your credit history and acceptance by a lender. If you choose to apply for a loan through us, a consumer report will be obtained to evaluate your creditworthiness in connection with your application for credit.
That's the sound of sizzling, dry-aged USDA Prime Wagyu and Angus steaks from UppercutChops.com. They're best-in-class filet mignons, New York steaks, and the king of all steaks, the tomahawk and cowboy cut ribeyes, are the best in the business. Even their Prime Wagyu burgers will likely be the best you've ever had. Browse the full selection of steaks and chops at UppercutChops.com from the comfort of your home or on your mobile device. UppercutChops.com delivers all-natural, dry-aged USDA Prime Wagyu and Angus steaks and chops directly to your door. store without the hassle of going to the grocery store and fight crowds to pick from a small selection of average at best meats with injected steroids, fillers, and coloring added to look good. Find out what's for dinner at uppercutchops.com or call
714-948-0100. Again, 714-948-0100.
Or make your selection directly at uppercutchops.com.
Welcome back to the Sports Circus. I'm Roy Firestone. Now it's time to throw it back to Sal.
Thank you, Roy, and welcome back to the Sports Circus. I'm your Ringmaster Sal, live from Las Vegas in the AMP TV studio, AAMP Television. This segment brought to you in part by our friends over at the College of Southern Nevada Athletics. Check them out at csncoyotes.com for upcoming games and events. That's csncoyotes.com for the College of Southern Nevada Athletics. And welcome back to everybody listening in on all of our network affiliates, CBS, NBC, Fox, whichever ones may be carrying us today, if you know what I mean. Hey, listen, folks, you never know. Anyway, big welcome in to everybody over in Honolulu on CBS Sports 1500 KHKA. That's home of the Yankees, the San Francisco 49ers, and the Alabama Crimson Tide. Of course, welcome in to everybody over in Atlanta on WDJY 99.1 FM, as well as WAUD over in Auburn, Alabama. Come on, War Eagle, what do you got going on over there? And a big welcome to everybody else on TV, Hotel TV, plus Cox, Comcast, Spectrum, Frontier, Time Warner, Oceanic, and WOW Cable affiliates in select markets. Everybody also on Facebook, thanks for joining us on Chicago Food Favorites. Folks, make sure you check that out. Chicago Food Favorites and everybody else on Pick Your Favorite streaming platform. All right. In the last segment, we're talking a little bit about this election effect on college sports. So in the last segment, it was a little bit about maybe pushing the envelope for this right or that right or whatnot, which party could do what and so forth. But now Title IX, it's an interesting part of this whole NCAA situation here. Now Title IX, as part of the House settlement, this is all according to Yahoo because they put their article out there. So I said, all right, I'm going to give you guys a little credit and we're going to go ahead and tell the world what you have to say. However, I'm going to put my own little spin on it, maybe afterwards, or I might even interject in the middle of it, if you know what I mean, just because I can. Anyway, as part of the House settlement, schools will be permitted, according to Yahoo, starting in July to share at least $20,500,000 annually with their athletes. The initial cap figure for the 25-26 academic year was distributed in a memo to Power Conference schools recently. Now, I like what they say. They're like, well, during the academic year, why don't they just call it the athletic year, if you know what I mean? Because really, isn't that really what we're talking about here? Because the athletic year sometimes is a little bit different than the academic year. Because remember, the academic year, in some cases, first of all, they may be on semester system. They may be on the quarter system. They may start a little bit different. You never know. And what if they're all year round? So is there technically a year? Some people start in the spring and they finish in the spring. That's their individual academic year. Kind of like when you file a corporation, let's say you start a new company, and what's your fiscal year, your end date, or better yet, your starting date? Maybe your starting date of business is, I don't know, February 1st. So if it's Feb 1, well, they say, well, that means your taxes due, your year end is January 31st. Well, technically, that would be their business year. So, and I say this about this academic year, they're talking about, well, the 25-26 academic year, blah, blah, blah. Well, the problem is the academic year doesn't necessarily coincide with the athletic year. So they're going to have to make a change in the way their legalese reads in these bills that they're submitting through Congress. And I can say that because I participated in a bill that went through Congress. And I know that it is a cumbersome process, but there is a very nitpicky way to write these things. And if you don't follow the correct legalese on it, then you got a bigger problem. So if you ever hear anybody talking about, well, now we have a new athletic year, you can credit your ringmaster, Sal. Thank you very much. All right. So as they state, the interpretation and enforcement of Title IX in the new era of athlete revenue sharing is perhaps one of the most overshadowed and important matter within college sports industry. See how they say college sports industry. Title IX is the federal law requiring educational institutions to offer equal opportunities and benefits to men and women athletes. But then again, they're talking about educational institutions. And that is the opposite of an athlete playing a sport. They just happen to be going to one of these educational institutions, one of these colleges or universities. Anyway, the U.S. president has significant influence over the direction of the Office of Civil Rights, the U.S. Department of Education, office responsible for preventing discrimination in education. Didn't talk about sports. The president is charged with both making appointments of leadership positions as well as directing leaders within departments. So, experts believe that a victory from the blue team, attempting to be whatever, will result in a more serious approach to the enforcement of Title IX as it relates to the distribution of revenue. So, look, this is when you have a liberal outlet like Yahoo, which is essentially pandering for the blue team, and they'll find everything wrong with the red team. Now, I'm not picking sides or nothing. I'm just stating these are facts and they're undisputed because Yahoo is a liberal media outlet, as most of them are. Nonetheless, this McMillan character says again, quote, that's going to be a big factor, and she would be taking office right when this whole House thing happens. I've talked to a lot of Democratic members. The distribution method, according to them, is not sitting well with a lot of female members of Congress. Close quote. So what is the distribution method? There's not one. Schools are permitted to distribute House-related revenue how they see fit. However, most plan to distribute the money unequally to their athletes using the House settlement back damage formula for the distribution, or 90% to football and men's basketball. So, somebody believes that the blue team would be more sympathetic to the historical and ongoing discriminations that women face. I don't necessarily believe that. I think that's a bunch of crap. So, again, that is just media spin. So, you could say, well, party A is going to do this, party B is going to do that. At the end of the day, all this stuff is wrong anyway, because athletes are what? They're student athletes. They're not athlete students. And frankly, if they don't make the grades, they shouldn't be allowed to play sports. If they don't make the grades, they shouldn't be allowed to share in any financial whatever. Oh, but they're putting their bodies in line for damage and this and that. They knew what the risk was playing in the first place. So I don't want to hear this, well, they're putting their lives on the line. No, they're not. Look, and you can make the same argument. I make the same argument for police and for fire and for military. These people are not drafted into those positions. They're all working for a wage of sorts. The police are, the firemen are, and the military, yes, they go in with good intentions, whatever. Some of them don't come back that good. But nonetheless, they all go in knowing that there's an inherent risk to the job. That's a matter of fact. That's not fiction. And that's not opinion. There is risk. If you're going to play sports at whatever level, there is always a risk of injury. And who knows what the extent of an injury could be. It could be one of those hangnail kind of things, or it could be a career-threatening one. So I don't believe that administration A or B is going to be better or worse for this whole college money ripoff NIL thing in the first place. That's how I feel about it. Nonetheless, there's also the issue of employment, and this is the last section of it. And of course, Yahoo says the endeavor to have college athletes deemed employees is a years-long movement that has divided college sports stakeholders. A growing group of administrators and even coaches now believe employment is a path to stability and the regulation of an unwieldy system leaders of athletes' rights groups such as X, Y, or Z, I'm not going to name them because I don't really give a damn to, they have led the employment movement now for years. Why? Because they want their cut. That's why, plain and simple. Just like unions, just like these collectives, they all want their cut. They're going to skim off the employees, or better yet, skim off the student athletes, or better yet, we'll call them athlete students at this point. Meanwhile, the NCAA officials and many power conference administrators have strongly pushed against employment. And even some blue team lawmakers have publicly acknowledged that the employment for college athletes is not the right path. So where does this end up? It may hinge on the election results, says the founder of a college sports players association, whatever. And he says, quote, "The first way the election can impact college sports is whether or not athletes are employees," close quote. Listen, buddy, they're not employees. They are students, college students. They don't work for a wage 40 hours a week or whatnot. They don't. They are students that happen to play sports. Get that through your head, Mr. I'm not going to say your name. Nonetheless, he goes on and contends that for now, two routes exist for athletes to become employees: through the courts or through a tribunal such as the National Labor Relations Board, which always seems to muddy the water, in my opinion. And the NLRB is actively pursuing unfair labor practices against a couple of schools out on the West Coast and one in the Ivy League. And so, look, this is just turning into be one gigantic dumpster fire. Why? Because money. Money is wrecking everything. Absolutely everything. You know why? As soon as somebody gets paid something, there's always somebody there to skim off of them. Now think about that, folks. There's always there. What do you think the unions do? The unions, basically, they push for higher wages. Why? So they push up their union dues. It's all the same thing. Garbage in, garbage out. There's always a pay at the end of all this garbage. So listen, folks, don't support this whole NIL thing because it's wrecking college sports as we know it. And frankly, it's wrecking the academic system as well. Back here in a few minutes on the circus, going to go into the rankings when we come back. I'm your Ringmaster Sal of the Sports Circus, a primetime, nationally syndicated television, radio, sports, and entertainment show. The Sports Circus covers topics others are too scared to talk about. There's no other primetime show like it on here that'll punch you in the face and you'll beg for more. Join me, Hall of Famers, World Champions, and All-Star Celebrity Guests for chaos and controversy here on Libsyn and all podcast platforms, plus thesportscircus.com. Remember, folks, it's a circus and we prove it every day.
Hello, Americans. It's Uncle Sam here. If you owe $10,000 or more in back taxes to the IRS or state, don't worry. I've got important news that may help you negotiate a lower tax bill. In today's economy, the IRS has released a variety of new rules and is offering more flexible terms to help Americans looking to settle their IRS debt. If you apply today, we may be able to lift your wage garnishments and release a freeze on your bank assets or business. Our team of tax professionals can resolve your case and stop collection actions against you. Even if you've been audited or haven't filed a return in years, they can help. Call right now and find out if you qualify to settle your IRS debt for far less than what you owe. Pick up your phone right now and call us for a free $500 IRS tax review. Don't wait. Here's the number.
Call right now. 800-950-2049. 800-950-2049. 800-950-2049. For the last time, that's 800-950-2049.
Do a search on how to get out of credit card debt, and you'll find everything from crazy promises to ways you can try to do it yourself. Many of those ideas just don't work, and they leave you broker than you were. Here's some advice. Call our debt helpline. In a quick and free 5-minute conversation, our experts will listen to you and learn about how much credit card debt you have, what your goals are, and then show you the right solution to help you get out of credit card debt with one new simple, affordable payment. The credit card companies make available special programs to help if you're struggling. All it takes for you to finally get out of credit card debt is one quick, free phone call. So please call right now.
800-948-6817. 800-948-6817. 800-948-6817. That's 800-948-6817. Paid for by the Debt Helpline.
That's ridiculous.
Quiet, numbskulls. I'm broadcasting.
Hey everyone, Dave Jackson here, ESPN rules analyst on ESPN Hockey, and you're listening to the Sports Circus.
Welcome back to the Sports Circus. I'm your Ringmaster Sal, live from Las Vegas in the AMP TV studio, AAMP Television. Folks, make sure to check out thesportscircus.com for our upcoming guests, our prior guests, to record shows, which are podcasts. No, we don't do a podcast. We just happen to store our full unedited audio files on Apple, Amazon, Audible, Spotify, Pandora, you name it, we're there. You can't get away from us. Also, make sure you check out the partners page. Lots of great partners over there as well. And of course, one of those is Al's Number One Italian Beef and 1079 West Taylor Street in Chicago's Little Italy. That's Al's Number One Italian Beef, 1079 West Taylor Street in Chicago's Little Italy. And if you can't make it over there, folks, make sure you check them out at alsbeef.com. That's alsbeef.com and pick up some really exciting food today. Yes! All right. And a big welcome in, everybody listening in on our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates and all of our independents from coast to coast, as well as Cox, Comcast, Spectrum, Frontier, Time Warner, Oceanic, and WOW Cable Television affiliates in select markets, hotel TV, and over 500,000 rooms from coast to coast, plus everybody on Chicago Food Favorites. Of course, we want to give everybody a nice shout out to there. As a matter of fact, what we're going to do is we're going to even run a live feed over there right now, just because we can. And listen, folks, this whole thing is live, and that's the best part about it. We don't fix it in the mix. We don't do anything in the mix. We just put it out there, and hopefully, the content is good enough and people don't get too irritated with the value or the quality of the content, because you never know what's going to happen, folks. Remember, it is live, and of course, anything can happen. And this particular show, it's almost as if anything will happen. So again, welcome in, everybody, on Chicago Food Favorites, live here at the Sports Circus. And we're here in segment number 3. I'm going to talk a little bit about college football. By the way, folks, make sure you check out Chicago Food Favorites and you join the group on Facebook. I'm going to say it 100 times because I'm the administrator for it. It's fun. It's something different. It's weird. It's free. And we like free and weird, if you know what I mean. That's all good stuff. All right. So a little bit of shakeup in the rankings, not too much, in the college football rankings as we go into, we'll call it week number 10. It's kind of maddening to imagine here. And we're going to start out at the bottom of the top 25. And of course, the top 25, yeah, you never know who it is and who's full of crap and who isn't full of crap. Who are the contenders? Who are the pretenders? Louisville with three losses. The only reason they're in the top 25 right now is because they have themselves a win over Clemson. And Clemson seems to be a little bit overrated, even ranked at number 19. We'll get to them in a minute. Louisville, 33. Clemson 21. Ranked number 24 is a surprise, and Vanderbilt, they deserve it. Even with three losses, they deserve to be in the top 25. They've got that big win over Alabama, big win over Kentucky as well. These guys are legit, and they just beat Auburn. Come on, War Eagle, what are we doing over there? And they beat them 17-7, and that was, in fact, over in Jordan-Hare Stadium in Auburn, Alabama. Not really a good situation over there. Number 23, Pittsburgh, drops five slots with their abysmal loss. And did I mention abysmal? Because it was awful. 48-25 to SMU. But SMU is a quality club. We're going to get to them in a minute. Kansas State drops five slots to number 22 with their loss at Houston, 24-19. Colorado jumps up two slots to number 21 with their 34-23 win on the road at Cincinnati. Colorado now moves to 6-2. Washington State from the Pac-2, but you can call them the Pac-7.5. Not really sure what to call them right now. Washington State with a win over San Diego State next year, who will be in the Pac-7.5. Of course, they're looking for an eighth member, so go ahead and apply within if you're looking to do so. 29-26, and that was at San Diego State. Clemson, number 19, they dropped eight slots to number 19 with that loss at Louisville. It doesn't really warrant an eight-slot drop, if you know what I mean. Army jumps up three. They jump up three slots with their win 20-3 against the Air Force Academy. Army is now 8-0. Pretty exciting. Iowa State drops six slots to number 17 with their one-point loss over in Lubbock, Texas to the Iowa State Cyclones. And Iowa State is playing really good ball. As a matter of fact, they're playing good ball, but they did lose to Texas Tech. They're down to 7-1, but they dropped six slots. Ole Miss jumps up three to number 16 with their big win against Arkansas on the road in Fayetteville. Texas A&M drops five slots with their drudging at the hands of South Carolina, the Gamecocks, 44. Texas A&M, an abysmal 20. Number 14, LSU, they jumped up two to get to number 14 with a win over, well, let's put it this way. It wasn't really a win, but by default, they jump up two. I'm not really sure how that happened. But at the end of the day, they jumped up two slots. SMU, as I mentioned earlier, listen, folks, this is live. Anything could happen. SMU jumps up seven slots with their win, their big win, as I mentioned previously, at Pittsburgh, 48-23. Boise State with Heisman candidate leader Ashton Jeanty. Man, this kid is something. If you haven't seen this kid play, watch a Boise State game if you can, because those guys are pretty damn good. They play in the blue field, too, so that makes it even a little bit more weird. But nonetheless, Boise State with a real nice win against San Diego State. Alabama jumps up three to number 11, 34-0 at Columbia. That would be Columbia, Missouri. That's unbelievable. I can't even believe that one. Notre Dame drops two slots, even though they beat the daylights out of the Naval Academy, 51-14. Up next for them is Florida State. Brigham Young remains idle at number 9, 8-0, because they had a win against Central Florida in their last game. Number 8, here's the big surprise of the year. And you know what? I'm a Purdue guy. I'm rooting for one team in the state of Indiana. It certainly isn't Notre Dame. It's the Hoosiers. They're 9-0. That's crazy. The 9-0 Hoosiers, they just really put a whooping on Michigan State in East Lansing, 47-10. Now, they've got three games left in the schedule. We're going to get to them in a minute. Tennessee, good old Rocky Top, with a win at Kentucky. They're at 7-1 in their last game. Up next for them will be Mississippi State. That's next Saturday at 4 p.m. Pacific time. Number 6, Penn State drops three slots. Yes, they were at number 3. Now they're at number 6 with their 20-13 loss against Ohio State. Not really a good situation there. Texas jumps up one to number 5 with their win against Vanderbilt. Yes, who knew that you can actually jump up in the top 5 with a win against Vanderbilt? But Vanderbilt, again, like I said, they are a much improved club. And also number 4, Miami. with a very big win over in Durham, North Carolina, over a very good Duke team. 53-31, Miami jumps up one. They are now 9-0 as well, and they are ranked number four. Ohio State jumps up one slot with their very close win against Penn State. Yes, they have 1,442 votes, and they sit 7 votes behind the University of Georgia, who is 7-1. Of course, up next for them is Ole Miss, and that should be a wild shootout. And number one, Oregon, all over Michigan and Ann Arbor, 38-17. 38-17, that's a big win. Oregon, make no mistakes, they are the number one team in America. Up next for them is Maryland. And when we look at these football standings, we say, well, geez, is Oregon that good or is the Big Ten that bad? I don't know, because Indiana is in first place in the Big Ten. How do you like that? In fact, we're going to give them an astounding round of applause. Just because, when's the last time you saw Indiana on top of the Big Ten? I don't ever recall seeing in my lifetime the Indiana Hoosiers in first place in the Big Ten. Oregon number two, Ohio State in third place with Penn State with a tiebreaker over Penn State. Iowa a steady 6-3, 4-2 in the Big Ten, along with Minnesota. It has the same record. Illinois, don't even know what to get with those guys at 3-3. Michigan at 3-3 and 5-4 overall, just like Wisconsin and Washington, newcomer to the Big Ten. And you scratch your head with some of these, you say, well, geez, looking over at, yeah, the Big 12, and it's newcomer Brigham Young leading the way at 8-0. Iowa State right behind them at 7-1. Conference USA, the Western Kentucky Hilltoppers always seem to be there. I don't know what it is, but boy, those guys play pretty good ball. Mid-American is Western Michigan, 4-0 overall, leading the Mid-American. The Mountain West shows Boise State cruising along, but yet Colorado State is in the rearview mirror with the same conference record. Pac-12, or better yet, the Pac-2, doesn't matter. The SEC has Georgia on top at 5-1, along with Texas A&M. And in the Sun Belt, it's Georgia Southern and the Raging Cajuns of Louisiana. Back here in a few minutes on the Sports Circus. Lots more to come, folks. Don't go anywhere.
Can your IRA stand up to the next financial crisis that our top economists are saying is at our doorsteps? By allocating a percentage of your IRA into physical gold and silver with a tax-free rollover, you can diversify and safeguard your holdings from turbulent markets and economic downturns by putting your IRA back on the gold standard. Find out how to safeguard your assets with a tax-free rollover with a Genesis Gold IRA, the only IRA that can hold physical precious metals. Call now for your free gold and silver report. Protect your IRA today with one simple phone call and learn how to qualify for up to $10,000 in free silver. Call Genesis Gold Group, empowering faith-driven stewardship. 800-932-5517. 800-932-5517. 800-932-5517. That's 800-932-5517.
If you served in the Marine Corps, by now you know about the contaminated water problem at Camp Lejeune. If you were stationed or worked at Camp Lejeune from 1953 to 1987, you probably have a lot of questions. We have some answers. You could be entitled to compensation. Billions of dollars are being allocated to pay for damages to anyone stationed at Camp Lejeune during that time. Unfortunately, it appears that officials may have known the contaminated water problem existed and did little to protect their men. The Semper Fi Code was not honored. If you or someone in your family has developed a serious illness, including various forms of cancer, call this Camp Lejeune legal support line right now. You can't turn back the clock and change what happened, but you can certainly call right now and learn your rights as a Marine. Here's the number.
Call 800-335-7196. 800-335-7196. That's 800-335-7196.
Do a search on how to get out of credit card debt, and you'll find everything from crazy promises to ways you can try to do it yourself. Many of those ideas just don't work, and they leave you broker than you were. Here's some advice. call our debt helpline. In a quick and free 5-minute conversation, our experts will listen to you and learn about how much credit card debt you have, what your goals are, and then show you the right solution to help you get out of credit card debt with one new simple, affordable payment. The credit card companies make available special programs to help if you're struggling. All it takes for you to finally get out of credit card debt is one quick, free phone call. So please call right now.
800-948-6817. 800-948-6817. 800-948-6817. That's 800-948-6817. Paid for by the Debt Helpline.
Hey, everybody. This is Brian Urlacher. Welcome back to the Sports Circus.
Welcome back to the Sports Circus. I'm your Ringmaster Sal, live from Las Vegas in the AMP TV studio, AAMP Television. Folks, again, make sure you check out thesportscircus.com for our upcoming guests, our prior guests, our recorded shows, which are our podcasts. No, we don't do a podcast. We just happen to store our fully recorded shows on those platforms, as I mentioned previously. So if you're ever bored for, I don't know, 3 or 4 months, whatever, go on a listening binge and listen to a few months nonstop of the Sports Circus. Because we've got over 2,000, almost 2,100 shows in the hopper for you to listen to. Some are pretty damn funny, and some of them, well, you know, they're pretty good. Not everything is great, and that's okay, because everybody has an off day. Yes, even Patrick Mahomes can sometimes get a interception actually counted against him rather than the officials saying, no, you've had 17 thrown in the last so long, we're not going to go ahead and count that against you. Don't worry about that. That's the kind of crap that seems to happen with good old Patrick Mahomes and those guys. Anyway, all right, back here on the Sports Circus, and welcome back to everybody. I'm Chicago Food Favorites, plus everybody else on CBS, NBC, Fox affiliates, independents from coast to coast on, well, let's put it this way, about 200-odd stations have access to this content, so you never know which ones are going to play it, and when they're going to play it as well, we don't know either. So roll the dice. You never know what's going to happen. All right. Now, I've spent a lot of time talking about college football from legislation to the rankings and this and that and to the standings. How about this? How about the odds of winning the national title? Well, and this is according to Pick Your Favorite Sports Book. Now, what I'm doing, I'm looking at a combination of a few online betting venues, which I will not name because they're not paying me, but I will name because I'm here in Las Vegas, MGM Resorts, Caesar's Palace, Bally's, and then there's another one that I won't mention right now. I know this. I'm surprised the Station's Hotel doesn't have theirs. So let's zoom in. For everybody on Facebook that's watching, because I'm streaming this, I'm just doing a live Ross feed here. It's kind of fun. So for everybody watching this on Facebook, you'll see that the odds-on favorite to win the national title is Ohio State. And I could say it that way because I went to a rival, and I think, in my opinion, I think they cheat. It is what it is. I mean, well, how do you spend $120 million in your recruiting budget on an annualized basis? Can you show me a line item disclosure of where that money was spent? I would love to see that. Anyway, they are a plus 350 at MGM. So if everybody watching on this live video feed, you watch the mouse here as I go over these. They're at a plus 350. So basically, you put up 100 to win 350. Over at Caesar's Palace, they're at a plus 360. At Bally's, they're at a plus 330. So if you're betting on those guys, you probably want to make that bet at Caesar's because you got an extra 10 cents on the line, or better yet, an extra $10 here, as it shows. That's the highest one. That's what's highlighted in yellow for everybody watching the video side of this. Oregon is, it looks like the average is about, they're about a plus four, we'll call it the consensus is plus 450. And MGM's got him at plus 450. Bally's got him at plus 450. Caesars got him at plus 425. Georgia, the highest price you can get for Georgia is a plus 425. So put up 100 to win 425, or better yet, put up 10 bucks to win 42 bucks and 50 cents, right? Or put up a dollar to win $4 and 25 cents. But the minimum you could bet, I believe, is $2. So nonetheless, we'll use the $10 one because that's more palatable for a lot of people. Now, Texas, somehow, I don't even understand this. Texas is not the fourth best team on this list. They're not even the fifth best team in college football, as the rankings show. Nonetheless, they're at plus 500 at most of the outlets. But if you bet them over at Bally's, you could get Texas at a plus 625. So you get an extra, well, according to the others, an extra, what, 20%? An extra 22%, 25%, whatever the hell it is. Anyway, you get an extra 20%, we'll just call it, if you're betting them over at Bally's, which everybody, again, can see on TV. That's what I'm doing right here. Now, Miami, who is really playing good ball right now, and they are underpriced. Miami is underpriced so much. They're undefeated, and they play in a pretty good conference, of course, in the ACC, but they're at a plus 1,200. Now, that's really good money for a team that is ranked number four, yet they come in number five on this odds ranking. Everybody could see that. They're one, two, three, four, fifth down. Now, behind them, an even better buy, which is a personal favorite of mine just because of friends and I like the squad, is the University of Tennessee. Rocky Top, you could get them at plus 2,000, or basically you put up 100 to win 2,000. Now, that's a really good price. Now, if you're betting over at MGM, you'll only get a plus 1,800, so 100 to win 1,800. You're much better off with the other venue here, which I'm not going to state the name. But those guys got them at plus 2,000. It's one of those online betting ones. Alabama somehow is at a plus 1,600, plus 16, plus 14. But the best prices you can get is at one of the casinos, at two of the casinos, at which is plus 1,800 at MGM and Bally's. I don't think Alabama's got it this year. I think that's a colossal waste of money, in my opinion. But then again, what do I know? Penn State is a better shot, even though they just lost to Ohio State. Penn State, you could pick them up at plus 2,500 if you bet it at Bally's. 2,500. So you put up 10 bucks, and you can actually win 250 bucks in return. Now, I did that with the World Series last year. I bet the Texas Rangers in the preseason when they were in spring training, and I got them at 50 to 1, and they came in, believe it or not, at 50 to 1. That, in fact, was a good one.
Show me the money!
Oh, yeah, they showed me the money. Notre Dame is at plus 3,500. So if you're one of those Golden Domer wannabe, whatever the hell, you could pick them up at 35 to 1 to win the national title. Ole Miss, who is really fun to watch, one of the more fun clubs to watch, those guys are at plus 3,500 essentially across the board. If you're the gambling type and you like offense, Ole Miss is your team. Now, Indiana, the sentimental favorite, only because for a lot of people, they want to see David slay Goliath, right? They want to see the improbable. Indiana is at the same price at plus 3,500 everywhere. I got to tell you, I might even put 10 bucks on that to win 350 bucks just by chance in case they happen to do it. That in itself seems to be a really good price. LSU is at plus 5,000. They don't have it this year. Those guys are on the toilet. Clemson, you don't have it either. That's why you can pick them up at plus 6,000. Texas A&M, forget it. You could pick them up at 100 to 1 in three different locations. But oddly, one of these locations have them at 50 to 1, and that would be Caesar's Palace. While Bally's, if you go, well, essentially across the street, well, you can pick them up at double the price. Now, that's a big win. SMU, a very good squad. Again, just joining the ACC. Those guys, you could get them at 75 to 1. SMU's playing really good ball, just not good enough. Brigham Young, who's undefeated, you can get them at 150 to 1. 150 to 1 over at Bally's. Why not? Brigham Young plays really good defense. For all you that know football, but you don't know college football, or better yet, you don't follow any other teams except the SEC. You better pay attention to Brigham Young because those guys can play defense and they can score too. And there's, of course, Heisman candidate Ashton Jeanty's squad, the Boise State Broncos. Those guys are across the board except one outlet. They're all at 100-1. I wouldn't bet on it. I'd be more likely to put $10 on Brigham Young to win. Not bad, but I'll take $1,000 to $1. $1,000 for my $10. Iowa State is at a lofty plus 12,500 or 125-1. That's a pretty good squad right there. Dion's club is at 150-1. That's Colorado. Pittsburgh is at 600-1. Kansas State, a very good squad, is at 300-1. That's absolutely worth $10, in my opinion. I'm only doing this just because I can. And I'm sorry if you're bored to tears with it. Guess what? The show is almost over. Louisville, you can get them at 800-1. They're not good enough. Sorry, folks. And all these other teams going down the list, Illinois is at 200-1. That's pretty funny. 2,000-1. Funny stuff. But all the way down to the very bottom, Memphis is at 10,000-1. Oregon State, same thing, 10,000-1, essentially. Why does this stuff matter? Because sports betting matters. In my opinion, these games are terribly compromised. And because the games are compromised because of money and the name, image, and likeness money and all this other dog and pony show, what ends up happening with these squads is that you see, just like in the NBA, maybe the line is 2.5 on a game, and somehow, conveniently, the score ends up maybe a 2-point game or a 3-point game. So it's the hook that either beats somebody or you actually win by the hook. But generally speaking, it seems that money is compromising a lot of these games. And honestly, I'm a little embarrassed for the players. I'm embarrassed for the coaches. I'm even more embarrassed for the referees. Now, I had on Tim Donaghy, he went to prison for fixing NBA games. Yeah, he absolutely went to prison for that. And so people say, well, how does that happen? You know, how do we know? Well, look, Tim Donaghy, he had his issues, of course, when it came to fixing basketball games. He served, I think, 13, 14 months in prison. I had him on the show, and he was saying that he got beat up almost every day in prison. That's a show I should probably run back here because it was an evergreen show, so we basically can play it whenever. But I will say that Tim Donaghy is a stand-up guy. He's a good guy. He's a tough guy. When I say tough, I mean he got his ass whipped in jail on a regular basis. But guess what? He came out, he did what he had to do, and he's a good dad. He's a good guy. But listen, a lot of these games, as I see them, they're compromised. And listen, the NFL in their charter, in case you don't know, the NFL, it says in their corporate charter that it's an entertainment company. It doesn't say it's a sports company. It's an entertainment company. And if you don't know who founded the National Football League, folks, you better go find out. You better go ask somebody, because if I'm not mistaken, it's the same people that founded the Better Business Bureau. Now, if you don't know who founded them to legitimize their businesses, you better do some homework, because I will tell you what, those organizations were all put together by the same group. And believe me, when you grow up in that, you understand it. When you see it on TV, you understand it. And so listen, this stuff is all for entertainment purposes only, in case you didn't know. So if you're going to put your hard-earned money out there, folks, I mean, honestly, gambling is a very tough way to go. And I live in what? The gambling capital of the world and the entertainment capital of the world. That's where this show is from. And guess what? We're out of time here at the Sports Circus. I'm your Ringmaster Sal. We'll see you in about 23 hours right here on your favorite station. So until then, so long, everyone.
Can your IRA stand up to the next financial crisis that our top economists are saying is at our doorsteps? By allocating a percentage of your IRA into physical gold and silver with a tax-free rollover, you can diversify and safeguard your holdings from turbulent markets and economic downturns by putting your IRA back on the gold standard. Find out how to safeguard your assets with a tax-free rollover with a Genesis Gold IRA, the only IRA that can hold physical precious metals. Call now for your free gold and silver report. Protect your IRA today with one simple phone call and learn how to qualify for up to $10,000 in free silver. Call Genesis Gold Group, empowering faith-driven stewardship. 800-932-5517. 800-932-5517. 800-932-5517. That's 800-932-5517.